Hey everybody, I'm Hannah Alper and I'm so excited because I'm sitting here with the amazing Sophia Bush. She's an actress and activist and I'm so excited to talk to you. So thank you so much for taking the time to talk to me at AZA BBG International Convention 2020.
Thank you.
So you grew up in Pasadena, California, and it's safe to say that you've been an activist since you were very, very young. Mm. How did your passion for activism and making a difference begin?
I think it was really environmental issues that struck me first growing up in Southern California. You know, we live in this beautifully environmentally diverse place with forests and the desert and the ocean, and everything kind of intersects in really beautiful ways. And understanding that we had a problem then as a kid it makes me very frustrated that we're getting worse, not better now. But we're trying. And that was really the beginning for me, wanting to start a beach cleanup crew in elementary school and realizing that no kids wanted to go clean up the beach on a Saturday, so my mom would take me by myself. She was pretty cool. And I think that was really the beginning.
I love that. I remember one of my first acts as an activist was a shoreline cleanup right by my house, and got my friends, and my mom was also a huge supporter. So I love that. And it's always the little things that add up and all that kind of stuff. Yeah.
Yeah, I think if everyone can identify something that they're passionate about, a problem that they want to have a hand in fixing, the world would be a much better place quickly.
I love that. And one of the ways that you make a difference is through social media and through your podcast, Work in Progress.
Yeah.
So can you talk a little bit about social media for social good?
I still believe in it as a tool. And the reason that I decided to join social media platforms was to talk about an environmental crisis and then other human rights issues that are happening in the world around us. And it is part of the reason that I wanted to start the podcast, because I realized that being able to share and disseminate information on all of these social channels is great, but it's the longer form space for conversation, learning, admitting we don't know everything, hearing from experts, really getting into thoughtful discussion that I think is the next wave of welcoming more people to the table and making people realize we're much more alike than different.
How do you think that we can kind of interlope activism and the entertainment industry so that everyone is saying what they're passionate about, just like you are?
Well, I think we've seen much more of a kind of tilting in that direction in the last couple of years. You know, a lot of people in entertainment historically have been encouraged to not be political so that they don't alienate anyone. But I don't see why my voice is any less valuable than the voice of someone who works at a hospital or a bank. We're all members of this citizenry. We are voting, hopefully, voting members of this country and countries around the world, and we deserve to have a say in how our government works or doesn't work for us. And I think there have been people historically who've been very courageous, and at least for me personally, I couldn't imagine not speaking up, not advocating for my neighbors and my community. And so I'm excited to see more and more people feel like they have to say something about what matters to them.
It seems like that you're so passionate about people and kind of storytelling, I guess, and you're very good at it. I feel like everyone has a gift that they use to make a difference, and that's clearly yours.
Thanks.
And when do you feel the most you, the best and the most confident?
I mean, I would certainly say when I am advocating for something, when I'm showing up for something, or on the sort of flip side of the coin, when I'm home somewhere quiet offline with my best friends.
You know,
those are the spaces that I feel the most me, and part of it's personal and part of it's purpose.
Right.
And they both matter, but I'm working on achieving a little more balance, certainly.
I love that. Self-care balance is very important.
Yeah.
And what do you think about the power of young people? You know, where you just came from speaking to a huge amount of young people who are all want to make a difference. So what do you think about the power of young people in making a difference and making the world better? And what's your advice for those that are looking to start but don't quite know how?
I want young people to know how powerful and valuable they are. And then I think it's on you guys to go out there and do just a little bit of the research, do a little bit of the work, figure out what you care about. And you don't have to have all the answers, but if you can identify something that matters to you, go toward it. help the helpers. There's already people working on every issue that is plaguing the world. So show up and help those people, learn from those people, and before you know it, you'll be a helper and there'll be new kids showing up to help you.
Help the helpers. Mm-hmm. I love that. And this is just a random question that I just thought of. What do you think? What's your mantra, I guess? You know, if you said help the helpers, and I immediately kind of thought of that, something that you would say to yourself every day in the mirror if you could.
That's a big one. And I think it's also just do the next right thing. Mm-hmm. This idea that we have to have all the answers, it can paralyze people. It can make people feel like what comes next is so overwhelming, and if they get it wrong, they're going to screw it up, and so then they just don't do anything.
Right.
That's not it. And I have this wonderful friend, Glennon Doyle, who's an amazing author, and that is what she tells her kids all the time. She says, just do the next right thing. And I think it's so powerful. So I got that one from her and have made it part of my daily set of reminders to myself.
I love that.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for sitting down and talking with me and for coming and speaking to all 3,000 teens at IC. It means so much to all of us. And thank you for doing what you do and for making the world better and for using your voice and your vote, of course.
Thank you. This has been very great.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thanks.